right, pal, but I just needed more. You get it, right? You're a machine, so I needed more. What's your lot in life? Serve humans, right? Well, I used to serve folks, too. I served in Kursk, and I served in Berlin.
Ugh, what do I do now? Lug this shit to the boiler myself?
I didn't do it just to get a fancy medal. I was fighting for equality, so everybody can have the same rights and responsibilities. So everybody could be like everybody else. Now, I just need to figure out how to put the damn thing on.
Are you sure? It's a good thing the pipe's opening's in the next room, and not over by the birch tree.
Possession and dissemination of experimental data constitutes a crime against the Communist Party, and is punishable by capital punishment.
Thank you.
Second one's all set. Second one's all set. Came up with all this shit. I'm sick to death of shoving balls into tubes.
We're doing this so we can leave the Vavilov complex.
Why can't I just, I don't know, walk out a regular door?
I'm afraid only an irregular door is available.
Comrade Major, have you found Dr. Filatova yet?
The one who helped Petrov butcher hundreds of people? No. She's still crawling around somewhere.
I emphasize that Dr. Filatova must not be hurt. If her life is threatened, you must come to her defense.
What? Rescue the bitch whose fault it is I'm wading knee-deep in gore? What the fuck?
Traitor Petrov used Dr. Filatova without her knowledge. She had no inkling of his true intentions. I mean the viciousness of his homicidal maniac. Her guilt must be established by a court of law.
Too good for her.
She deserves no less. Dr. Filatova is a renowned neural surgeon. Dr. Sechenov entrusted her with a collective research that connected both humans and robots. She must not be hurt. Did I make myself clear, Comrade Major?
I'll keep it in mind. What's the hot workshop used for?
Heat-resistant polymers are made here. but most of the research is dedicated to the cultivation of heat-resistant flora.
Nice.
The polymers here are enriched with essential oils from Cacticae cereris, a cactus. The polymers make it possible to cultivate groups of plants that are adapted to high temperatures.
Do they want to make the desert greener or something?
Something like that. They plan to terraform Mars. Canisters fill automatically once the temperature is normalized.
Everything here seems pretty cut and dry. We should head back before something fucked up happens. What do we know about Petrov's girlfriend, Charles?
Are you referring to Dr. Filatova?
That's what I said. Did the cat get your tongue? Do you know her?
Dr. Larissa Filatova, MD, has worked with Dr. Sechenov for many years. He entrusted her with one of the most crucial aspects of Collective 2.0, with good reason. She replaced the late Chariton Zaharov in that role.
Who's Zaharov?
A tenured professor of medical science, an esteemed neurosurgeon, and one of the scientists who vanquished the Brown Plague. Chariton Radionovich Zaharov was also Dr. Sechenov's closest friend and trusted colleague. They laid the foundation for Facility 3826 together.
Great, whatever. So what about Filatova?
She's a talented neurosurgeon and was Comrade Zaharov's student and assistant. She continued the professor's work after he died. But she is now a criminal and a traitor to the motherland.
Understood. It's too bad. She's kind of cute. What's this crap?
That is a sprout.
What's a sprout?
Sprouts were designed as highly efficient feed for large livestock. But there's something wrong with this sprout.
Killer chicken. Now I've seen it all.
Attracting their attention is not advised.
Too late. Not the rescue team, more like a vanguard.
Well, I'll be damned. Plenty of time has passed. There's still no alarm. No army coming to the rescue.
Did you see how all this got started? Can you tell me about it?
I don't want to, but I certainly can. The machines didn't attack right away. They sort of spread throughout the facility at first, so they could attack all at once. I suspected something was off the moment the lab tech robots all went into our offices and positioned themselves behind people's backs. Most of my colleagues died right at their workstations. What scared me most wasn't the killing, but the way they slowly walked towards the humans. It was kind of like gym class, when they tell you to split up into pairs.
How long ago did you die?
I don't remember, but I stayed alive longer than most. The machines couldn't get to where I was, since there was no way in. There was shooting, and then hoses started coming out of everywhere. Most people died in the first couple of seconds. Very quickly. Robots either smashed their heads in or snapped their necks, like popping the caps off soda bottles. We took to our heels, but then a lab tech grabbed Comrade Afanasyev. There was a soldier around who tried to stop them, but he just had time to say, oh, that's where I sort of stopped being scared and charged the robot. The last thing I remember is being dead.
I'm sorry. We're gonna take those motherfuckers down.
You can't blame the machines. Humans did this. Doesn't look like an accident to me. It'd take months to plan something like this.
Okay. They'll send someone for you once this is all over.
Frankly, it won't make much difference to me. Better make sure this contagion or whatever's wrong with the robots doesn't spread to the other complexes. Oh, the rescue team. Finally.
Sorry. Duty calls. Some other time. Oof, cold. What's with this place?
Its purpose is to study how living things can survive in a vacuum.
So it's for planting crops on the moon and stuff?
Among other things, yes. The research conducted here applies to a wide range of subjects, from primitive single-celled plant life to livestock and other animals.
That's some neat fish you've got in that aquarium. Clusterfuck.
Valentin Demjanovic.
Who? Me?
The computer mistook you for the head of this laboratory.
Reminder, it is time for you to take your blood pressure medication. Playing an excerpt from an automated recording of your last work shift.
Yes, much better. Opera is doing wonders. Definitely. So, on with my life. Day 783. Ah, yes. At first, it was extremely difficult for me not to pay any attention to this circle of life, as they call it. But then I realized there's something of an art form. Circle of life, indeed. Why do they even have to invent the name? Their superiors think that propaganda increases productivity. So to them, their employees are nothing but mindless swine, like these animals. Well, this isn't killing, it's just maintaining a circle of life. You know what, Oliver? Even if we are just swine, who gave us the right to mistreat the other swine, right? I'm awful sorry. I truly am. God knows it's true. You died a hero's death. I'm even thinking about building a memorial. I promise I wasn't. Sometimes I think that when put to classical music, the convulsions themselves become a kind of...
Crap, this thing's locked too. What is it this time?
You are leaving the laboratory. Before opening the door, please complete your experiment and save any data you have collected.
I didn't get anything mixed up.
I can't be right. Or can I? To hell with it. I should ask to be transferred to another department. If only temporarily. No. Keep your claws off that. Not this recording. Oh, okay, I'll switch it off.
Spinning. That should do the trick. Yeah, the handle's attached.
Authorized distribution of information will be constituted.
kill all of them.
It's standard to the manufacturing process. It's where the polymer's organic components come from.
Where'd they all go, then?
To the algae workshop. To undergo polymeric synthesis.
I don't even want to know. It's huge. I've never seen so many planters in one place before.
This is where they grow the plants that will be used to terraform the Moon, Mars, and Venus.
But right now it's not working for shit. We need to find the control panel. Shit. Nothing but dead bodies.
There's a power activation laser relay on the wall.
Okay, I can deal with that. But I will never get used to this shit.
Authorization. Major Nechayev, codename P3, access granted.
So, what will... Major, weapons, or ability.
How do I fill the canister?
The canister fills with cryopolymer automatically. We just need to wait.
That sounds a little too easy. Looks like we've got company. I knew there was no way we could just wait patiently for this thing. Say. Finally.
Data saved. Attention, employees. Access to the pesticide workshop is now available.